indeed take place. Now, moving on, the Kenya Women's Finance Trust, or as they are known today, the Kenya Women's Microfinance Bank, emerged tops in the 2016 edition of the Deloitte Best Company to Work For survey in the large corporate segment, while DHL Express Kenya emerged tops in the medium category. The survey, now in its fifth year in a row, was launched in July 2016 and aims to identify and rate the best companies to work for based on their most important stakeholder, that is, their employees. The survey measured 10 different parameters, including leadership, operational inclusiveness, inclusion, relationships with managers or supervisors, development, and job satisfaction, among other criteria. Ranking second in the category with more than 500 employees were East African Breweries, followed closely by CIC Insurance. Well, in that story right there, bringing us to the interview of the day and night, of course, as indicated earlier, now in studio with us to discuss essentially how this company managed to emerge tops is Mr. Mwangi Githega. He is the CEO of the Kenya Women's Microfinance Bank. Karibu sana, sir. Yeah, so did it come to you as a surprise that you emerged tops, first of all?
No.
Yes.
No, because we've been, this whole scheme has been running for the last 5 years. Mm-hmm. And for the last 4 years since it was started, we've always been among the top three. In mm-hmm. fact, we have emerged number two three times mm-hmm. and number three once. Mm-hmm. So it was just a question of time. In fact, we knew anytime soon we'll be top. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it wasn't a great surprise.
The question I know that's on everyone's mind currently is what exactly it takes to emerge tops, especially knowing that the voters here are your employees and other close stakeholders. What exactly does it take to be rated the best employer in town, basically?
Yeah. First, we have a big workforce. We have about over 2,900 employees
all across
who are spread in 45 of the 47 counties of this country, mm-hmm. and in about 241 branches. So that just tells you that we are really in the rural area. 80% of our activities are based in the rural area, mm-hmm. and the average age of our employee is 26 years. Mm-hmm. In fact, I am the one who tilts the balance a little bit. Mm-hmm. So we are dealing with the young generation, and these are people who initially may have been brought up in the urban areas, but we are posted in the rural areas. So it's quite some effort, and we have had to understand our employees mm-hmm. and look at their needs and run a fair institution, mm-hmm. an institution that everybody feels they belong, they own, mm-hmm. and it's theirs. And once you've done that mm-hmm. as a CEO, the rest of it becomes extremely easy. It's mm-hmm. not a question of pay. Mm-hmm. Pay is important.
Yes,
but it's not the only thing. It's about the work environment and how you manage that mm-hmm. environment.
Let's break that down a bit, because motivation, the drive to make people wake up charged and energized to go to work to make a difference, that day is important. Yeah. And especially for a workforce over 2,000 people strong, how exactly have you been able to create, well, so to say, a sort of operation that is able to customize that for everybody?
What we've done is that we've broken the country into five zones, and each zone is broken into about four regions, and each region has branches. Mm-hmm. What we do is we train our managers very well. Mm-hmm. Most of the managers are young also, because they also joined KWFT when they were very new and when they are straight from school. Mm-hmm. And so we train them on how to handle the employees, how mm-hmm. to look at the employees' need. Then we've created a very strong culture. Kenya Women is not very new. Mm-hmm. This institution is over 30 years old. It was started many years ago by women who felt that there was great need to empower mm-hmm. women and their families. Mm-hmm. So what we have done is we have created a very strong culture of ownership, a culture that everybody feels that, yes, this is my company. And we don't only just tell them, we actually demonstrate it. Mm-hmm. We make sure that we have a fair institution. We pursue the triple bottom line approach where, profit is important.
Yes.
But then you need to have a very strong social impact, both at the employees level and at the clients level. So whenever we are working with our people, may they be employees or clients, we try to run a fair institution that everybody feels that they belong.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Research has shown that a lot of Africa, and indeed a lot of Kenya, the economy is centered mostly around agriculture. Yeah. And youth and don't find that very enticing.
Yeah.
But recently it has emerged that the integration of agriculture and technology then creates something that can start to work for the youth.
Yeah.
How big is technology a part of the operation?
Okay, the target market we work with are women in the rural areas.
Yes.
And I just like I mentioned, this majority of them are in the rural. Yes. And what we do is we have a lot of engagement at one-to-one, face-to-face.
Mm-hmm.
So our employees engage our clients on one-to-one in the villages. They use motorbikes. They go up and down the valleys.
Mm-hmm.
And so the issue of technology only can go take us up to this level. Mm-hmm. It can go to the end.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a lot of personal contact between us and the client.
Mm-hmm.
So because of the business model that we have,
mm-hmm.
the issue of technology only can take us up to a certain level. Of course, we have mobile banking,
mm-hmm.
we have ATMs,
mm-hmm.
we have agency banking, that we do have. But the personal contact between us and the client is very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
And they also the kind of clients that we work with, they want personalized service.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they may not get that from machines.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to be to do that last mile.
Mm-hmm.
You need to be with them. So what we do is we equip our employees to do exactly that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Let's talk a bit about the operating environment, the fact that recently there is a law that has capped the interest rates for essentially commercial banks.
Yeah.
And there has been different fallouts from this.
Yeah.
Maybe you can just tell us what the effect has been on your segment of the economy, especially bearing in mind that there had been sentiment that customers would start to flee in that direction.
Yeah.
But as you're indicating, the demographics might be slightly different.
Yeah. We have different target markets. Mm-hmm. I think the financial sector is very wide.
Mm-hmm.
It starts from the big corporates to the micro customers who are in the rural area, who initially were completely excluded from participating within the economy.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the sector we focus on. We focus on the excluded people. We go where banks don't go.
Yes.
You know, commercial banks don't open.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't make sometimes sense to be in certain areas. But when you look at it from the kind of model that we have, where we are pursuing development, because development is quite important for us. We don't pursue pure profit. Profit is one of the things that mm-hmm. that we have, but we pursue the issue of are we making our people better off, or are mm-hmm. we making them worse off? So there are some times that we have products that we take very deep in the rural area. Right now, we are working with about 800,000 women customers
mm-hmm.
and their families.
Yeah.
And majority, more than 80% of them are very deep. In fact, we have offices in some of the areas that there is no commercial bank. We are in areas that initially it may not have made sense. So when we get those areas, we open the economy of those
mm-hmm.
areas.
Mm-hmm.
We make it possible. And then you find other service providers now coming to join and be able to offer services. So ours is a developmental agenda.
Mm-hmm.
So the issues relating to interest rate cap, it's very good. I would say it was the way to go.
Mm-hmm.
But because we all have to become good citizens. But what we do on our side is that we are socially responsible. In everything that we do, we look at exactly what does it mean to the customer and how does it impact the customer.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, the model is expensive. It's very expensive to be very deep in the rural area and give small loans. But those are the loans that make this country different.
Mm-hmm.
These are the loans that make our people mm-hmm. go to school, make our customer mm-hmm. be able to put food on the table. So
mm-hmm.
it's something that has to be done. There is no choice.
Yes, before I let you go, I have to ask, because it's something you've mentioned, how big is consumer education as a part of what you do? Because some of those people have never really interacted with any sort of financial services.
Yeah, that's part of our life. In fact, what we do is before we start funding our customers, we educate, we take them through a training for 8 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And during the period of training for 8 weeks, where we teach them on how to manage their business, how to keep books of accounts, how to know the difference between profit and turnover,
mm-hmm.
how to be able to look for markets. We do it for about of 8 weeks, and that's even mm-hmm. before they have started borrowing with us.
Yes.
Then after they have borrowed with us, then we meet them every month.
Mm-hmm.
We meet in group meetings, we pass skill. So our officers are trained to be able to pass skill so that financial literacy becomes very important. And that's part of what the financial sector needs to work on. Mm-hmm. We need to educate our people so that they can understand how to manage enterprises.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Indeed, thank you very much, Mr. Mwangi Gathiga, the CEO of the Kenya Women's Microfinance Bank, for coming in and giving us insight into this sector, which I must say is not really much talked about, the fact that banking also does have a social impact agenda and that you're very big in that field. Thank you for your time, sir.
Thank you very much. And we are happy to have come, and mm-hmm. we are doing the correct thing, and we are happy.